you sow?
Positive or negative?
If you're sowing negative, you say, well, I'm not sowing anything. How can that be negative? That's very negative. I come from a long line of farmers, awesome track farmers. And I never heard my granddaddy or my uncles say, well, we were expecting a big harvest this year, but I'm sitting in the house and I'm going to save these seeds and I'm expecting to come up on their own. I used to watch my granddaddy go out and he'd do his planting and then he would make his own little greenhouse and have fields that the plastic over top of. And I watched him so carefully and gingerly handle that seed. And as he handled that seed, I watched him. He took that seed and something amazing would come from it. I said, Granddaddy, why do you take such care of that seed? He says, if I take care of the seed and plant it properly, it'll take care of my family the whole year. And then there was a little field he had, just one field. And I said, well, Granddaddy, what's that field? He said, I can't touch that field. When I harvest it, he says, that field is God's field. He said, all these other fields are mine. When I go to market, that field belongs to God. So I learned a lot from my granddaddy. First, taking care of the seed, getting it ready for planting, and then planting it, and then taking care of it and harvesting. He was a good farmer. What I understand, my great granddaddy was one of the biggest farmers in that area. My granddaddy also taught me about that one field that was God's. He said, I wanted God's blessings on the rest of it. And so I give this to God and trust Him with the rest. Amazing. Amazing. What do you plan? Positive or negative? Again, life is an echo. What you send out comes back. If you're snappy at people, if you're rough at people, if you're intolerant of people, if you're impatient with people, it's going to come back. People are going to be impatient with you, intolerant of you. If you hold on to everything,
Tower.
Be cheerful when you go out there. Smile when you go out there. I was a disc jockey for about a year. I did gospel music time in the afternoon when I was pastoring the ministry. And the station manager came to me one day and he said, "You're not doing that right." I said, "What? I'm pushing all the buttons." You said, "I'm doing everything." He said, "No. Whenever you flip that switch and you're broadcasting, no matter how bad you feel, you smile." I said, "I'm on the radio." Matter of fact, somebody told me I had a face for radio. He said, "That smile will go out and people will feel it." And from that day forth, whenever I hit that broadcast button, I made sure I was smiling. Because people were out there needing a touch. They were needing help. It's amazing what a smile can do. Matter of fact, a smile is a cheap facelift. Did you know that? What if I stand? God is so good to us. I said this out of the mighty army a little while back. It's not that God has quit being good. It's just we've learned to quit being thankful. I got some people in my family just expect. They don't give, they just expect. A relationship has to be balanced. Always has to have some balance. And every relationship has to have balance. I know some people love it. Just give me, give me, give me. Give me, give me, give me. And when you need them, they're nowhere to be found. Just give me, give me, give me. I need you. Don't call me if you need me. And it makes it hard to help. And there's others that have been over backwards. I can't wait to be good to those folks. Because I know they're going to be good to me. It's balance in the relationship. You want some positive balance in your relationships. You want some positive balance in your job. You want some positive balance. Change the way you are. You can't change anybody else. Change what you're dishing out. If you can change what you're dishing out, you watch things change.
Christ, your personal Savior, every
get by every eye closed. And you want to know him as your Savior. Remember, you reap what you sow. This is sown to the Spirit, not to the flesh. If you don't know Jesus as personal Savior and you want to, with nobody looking around, you just slide that hand up and say, pray for me, Pastor. I need Jesus. Maybe you're here this morning and you're kind of going the other way. Things are kind of rough. Thank you. folks that's looking, because some of them think you're crazy. I want you to go in the bathroom or go to the vanity somewhere, and I want you to look in it. Look at you. I want you to practice talking like you normally talk at work. Practice talking. I know sometimes somebody can read and go, are you upset? No, I'm happy. Why are you looking like that? Practice what you look like. Because that's part of your soul. When people come up to you, they look at you. Write a song and they go, this is going to be a bad day. Practice. Matter of fact, that's what you do. Let's look at it.
Thank you.